The Financial Consumer Protection Act was signed into law last year to make investing in the Philippines safer. But as Lady Vicencio reports, scams are still rampant in the country.
For the last 3 years, Megan Talpo has been active in the high-risk investment environment of cryptocurrency. She's trained herself to be extra careful, knowing that there are many bad actors looking to scam investors out of their hard-earned cash.
Mas okay siguro to invest mas sa stocks or yung mga MP2 ng Pag-ibig or yung line po yung WIS Plus ng SSS kung mga, for example po, yung mga minimum wager. Mga ganun po, panatag po yung isip mo na, ah, ito after, for example po si MP2, pa after 5 years, meron talagang babalik. Unlike po kasi kay crypto, you should dig more po eh, na ano, kaya medyo critical siya. Ba probability ng loss po ng pera, yes po.
The Financial Products and Services Consumer Protection Act was signed into law in May 2022 with the goal of making investments safer in the Philippines. Regulators have been busy with it. The Philippine Central Bank and Insurance Commission have released their implementing rules and regulations, while the SEC released its own IRR this week. The Cooperative Development Authority has yet to release their version. But while regulators work to implement the law, scams have continued to operate. The SEC has been busy this year updating its website with new advisories against scams. And data from just one telco show there have been millions of malicious smishing attacks in the first quarter alone. For one financial planner, there is a need to protect the public not just from scams, but also from unfair treatment when dealing with financial products and services they don't necessarily understand. With financial literacy still quite low in the Philippines, Salve Duplito says the government needs to step up.
Anything na tungkol sa ating ipon, tungkol sa ating risk management tools, yung insurance, tungkol sa ating investments para sa ating pagre-retiro, dapat talaga pinag-iisipan, merong pag-iingat, at saka merong mga government mechanisms para matulungan ng ordinaryong tao na maibalik sa kanila sakali mang nakuha ang mga ipon na ito.
Looking at the SEC's IRR, it restricts excessive and unreasonable interests, fees, and charges for financial products and services. Violators can face penalties of imprisonment of up to 5 years and/or fines of up to 2 million pesos. The IRR also provides for a cooling-off period of not less than 3 days when it comes to purchasing products and services so consumers have a chance to fully understand what they are getting into.
Or nagdeposito or ganyan, tapos hindi niya makuha, hindi niya ma-withdraw, hindi niya ma-claim yung kanyang produkto. Saan siya pupunta? Prior to the IRR of the FCPA, hirap na hirap yung mga ibang mga consumer kasi minsan nag-chat-chat sila doon sa website ng isang kumpanya or tumatawag sa telepono pero wala silang makausap. Sana tutukan ng ating mga kababayan at ng mga consumer advocacy groups, mga financial advisors, kung papaano nga mai-implement.
The SEC's IRR officially takes effect 15 days from publication. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.